What's up, my Chroma Key and PD peeps? Thanks for choosing this video to get Learnalicious with PowerDirector. If you use PowerDirector and you haven't subscribed to my channel, please consider clicking the subscribe button and clicking the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. Green screens can be used to pull off a lot of cool tricks, and with PowerDirector and the Chroma Key tool, those tricks are just a few mouse clicks away. The first wonderful trick I'm going to share with you is the X-ray effect. The X-ray effect makes it look like you can do X-rays using your smartphone. You need a picture of an X-ray hand, which I have right here, and you need a video of a smartphone with a picture that's green on it, which I have right here. Now, what you want to do with that footage is you want to go ahead and record yourself waving the smartphone with the green screen picture over your hand so that it looks like you're X-raying your hand. Next, you want to place your footage into the timeline. You need to have your X-ray hand on track one, and then you need to have the footage of you waving the phone on track two. Next thing you want to do is use the PIP designer to resize the image of the skeleton so that it matches your hand in the footage. Once you get your hand in position, you can go ahead and leave the PIP designer. And then you want to go ahead and open up the footage of you waving the phone with the PIP designer. And you want to go ahead and enable the chroma key. And you can go ahead and play it back. And that's Irradiation Nation. If you want to see the full tutorial for this effect, there's going to be a link in the video description. Next, we have the Land of Oz effect. The Land of Oz effect makes it seem that you're passing through a door, a window, a keyhole, whatever you want to go through, from one world to another world. You'll need green screen footage of a door opening. And then you'll also need footage of whatever you want to go through the door to, whatever new world you're going to be in. So you need to place the footage that you want to show through the door on track one. And you need to place the footage of the door opening on track two. First, you want to go ahead and apply the chroma key to the door footage. Next, we want to go ahead and make the footage black and white because we want to make it different. So we're going to start off black and white and go through to a new world that's color. So we're going to go ahead and left click on the green screen footage. We're going to go to the effect room. We're going to go to the style effect. We're going to go to style. And we're going to grab filter color. We're going to left click on it and drag it down on top of the footage. It automatically makes that footage black and white. Now, if we click on effect, we can see that the focus color is green. That's the only color that was in there. So that means that the green is going to stay green. So the chroma key that we applied will not be lost by adding this effect. And now you're in the Land of Oz. You know the routine. If you want to see the full tutorial of this effect, there's a link in the video description. Now it's time to break down the invisible cloak effect. This effect makes it seem that a cloak can make whoever wears it invisible. You need a green screen to use as the cloak, and you need a different colored sheet to place inside the green screen so that you can actually see the cloak. You need to shoot the scene with the talent covering himself with the cloak. And then you also need to go ahead and shoot the scene with no one standing in it. When you shoot both of those scenes, make sure that the camera is on a tripod and make sure it's in the exact same place when you shoot both of those scenes. You'll need the clip with nothing in it to be on track one and the clip with the person pulling the green screen over them on track two. Then you want to go ahead and double click on the clip on track two to open up the PIP designer. You want to go ahead and select the chroma key. Click on OK. And then you might want to go ahead and add a transition to the end so that the guy can fade away, like fade into invisibility. Makes it more realistic. We can play this back.
Abracadabra.
If you want to see the full tutorial of this effect, there's a link in the video description as well. The next trick is the replace the sky effect. This effect allows you to replace the sky with a spaceship, a beanstalk, a giant peach, whatever the heck you want. What you'll need is a clip with the sky that's all one color. Make sure there's no clouds in it, anything like that. It's got to be one color. And then you want to go ahead and place the footage of the sky into track two. And you'll need to go ahead and place the footage of whatever you want to replace it with. So in this example, we're going to replace it with some stars. You need to have that in track one. Then all you really need to do is go ahead and double click on the click of the sky. Go ahead and apply the chroma key. And we just went from a beautiful day to a starry night. If you want to see the full tutorial of this effect, you know, yeah, there's a link in the video description. The last trick is the subscribe and like button effect. This creates a call out that you can use on all of your YouTube videos. You can download or screen record a subscribe and bell animation with the green screen background from YouTube. Just make sure that you have permission from the creator to use the content commercially for free before you use it. You want to place your footage on track one, and then you want to place the green screen footage on the bottom track of your project. You want to double click on that green screen footage. I'm going to go to the chroma key here, use the eyedropper to go ahead and select green, and then you want to move your playhead to a position where you can see the call out. We want to go to object settings, and we want to go ahead and resize this and drag it to a position where we want it to show up on the screen. And go ahead and click on OK. We can play this back. And now everyone will click subscribe and hit the bell when they watch your videos. It just got extra tricky up in here. If you like what you see, I'll leave links to try PowerDirector for free and buy PowerDirector in the video description. Using those links helps to support the channel so I can make more content for you. I know you want more PowerDirector love, so be sure to click on these videos to watch more of my content and smash my cartoon face to subscribe. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.